So today at queenbeing.com, we're going to talk about
10 TV shows and movies that feature narcissistic characters.
So let's get started.
Closed captioning provided by Athena Moberg and CPTSDFoundation.org.
My name is Angie Atkinson, and on this channel, I offer free daily video coaching to help you discover, understand, and overcome narcissistic abuse and toxic relationships. I like to call it toxic relationship rehab. So if that sounds good to you, hit that subscribe button and let's get going.
10 TV shows and movies that feature narcissistic characters. Starting with narcissists in the movies. Let's begin with The Devil Wears Prada. Miranda Priestly thrives on keeping her employees and everyone else in the fashion industry in fear of her narcissistic rage. Only briefly do you ever see any glimpse of humanity of her in the movie, and it's quickly remedied when you realize she's thrown one of her most loyal employees under the bus by giving her would-be replacement the promotion that should have been his in order to protect her own interests and keep her job at the magazine. Mean Girls. The Plastics, all of them, could be classified as narcissists in one way or another, though the two followers may be more codependent than anything. But their leader, Regina George, is clearly a raging narcissist who not only makes her followers tell her how skinny and beautiful she is, but she also has no problem using them to get what she wants. There's no doubt that she is certain she's better than everyone else, even her own rather enabling mother, Snow White. The wicked queen literally orders the death of her younger, more attractive stepdaughter for being, well, younger and more attractive. Looks to me like a histrionic narcissist if I've ever seen one. Mommy Dearest. This true story about actress Joan Crawford offers a classic example of a toxic, abusive, and blatantly narcissistic mother who uses and abuses her two adopted children emotionally, psychologically, mentally, physically, and otherwise. Dead Poets Society. Puck's father was a bullying, controlling narcissist who ultimately goes too far with his toxic abuse and loses his son to suicide. And, if we're being honest, the headmaster of the school could probably also be called narcissistic since he controls the students through threats and intimidation. Now let's talk about narcissists in television. Will and Grace. Karen Walker is a rich, beautiful, and blatantly narcissistic character. Rarely shows empathy, but the writers do seem to show enough of her human side that you don't quite hate her. House. Dr. Greg House is an amazing doctor, but he talks down to his patients, to the other doctors, and even his bosses. And except for a few peeks into a slightly human self, House rarely seems to show any empathy at all. Breaking Bad. Walter White is clearly a self-focused narcissist who initially seemed to mean well, but ultimately got so wrapped up in the toxic meth business that he apparently ends up dead. More intriguing, though, might be the character Gus Fring, who runs a chain of chicken restaurants, among other businesses, which act as a cover for a multi-million dollar drug ring. 2 and a Half Men. Charlie Harper, Alan Harper, and their mother Evelyn Harper. Each Harper brother is self-focused and entitled in different ways, and it's pretty clear that their narcissistic mother drove their personality development. Gilmore Girls. Lorelai Gilmore may be more of a covert narcissist, but she was raised by an obviously toxic mother, and she often appears to show no empathy for anyone outside of herself and her daughter, who, perhaps not surprisingly, she named after herself. The Sopranos. Tony Soprano seems to have some serious narcissistic traits, despite apparent empathy that he displays now and then. In fact, his therapist even noted during one episode, "I thought we were making progress with your narcissism, Tony." Olivia Soprano also seems to be on the narcissism spectrum.
Alright, now this brings me to the question of the day. And the question of the day is,
have you seen any of these movies, and if so, which ones? And what other movies would you say feature narcissists?
Share your thoughts, share your ideas, share your experiences in the comment section below, and let's talk about it. Want to give a quick shout out to my amazing channel members, the people who chose to sponsor my channel here on YouTube through that join button that you see below, or the link you see in the description if the join button isn't visible on your device. These are my inner circle people who get a little extra something, some perks from me, but also who help support this channel and make it better for everyone. I'm so grateful for each and every one of you. Thank you so much for being my insiders. My amazing inner circle includes
Angela Falsetta, Susan Marion, Roxanne Antle, Deborah, Black Caesar, Life's Revival, Trisha Wolf, James F., Marlene, Jen Archer, and Sarah Lee. Thank you.
Thank you all so much for being such a big, important part of this channel, and thank you for supporting me and my mission to help people discover, understand, and overcome narcissistic abuse and toxic relationships. It means the world to me. Thank you. All right. That's all I've got for you right now. But as always, thank you so much for being a part of my day and a part of my life. And hey, thanks for letting me be a part of yours. It really does mean a lot to me. Now, before I go, make sure you take a look at the videos I'm leaving for you right here and right here. And while you're here, hit that subscribe button right there so we can stay connected and continue on this healing journey together. I'll see you soon.